I want to start by asking you this question. Was there absolutely no grounds for you to have expressed your concerns within the party? And was this the only and only option left in front of you? Was the reason so important that you quit a grand old party with which you have stayed for many, many decades?
Yes, this was the only option before me, because I am in the party, not for any position, but I am in the party that I want a job satisfaction. Being in a party which is the democratic party, that is my satisfaction. The Congress party, when there is inner party democracy, when our opinions are heard, when we are part of the decision making, that satisfaction is what is pushing us forward. Now recently, the Kerala elections are around the corner. The candidates were to be decided. An election committee was formed. The election committee did not have any discussion on the candidates. Kerala two united fronts are equal. But the candidates list, if it is a presentable one, if it is a good one, then Congress front can win. But unfortunately, about these candidates, there was no discussion at all. I have brought this to the notice of the senior leaders of the party, but there was no corrective steps taken. Congress party in Kerala is working as two separate parties, not one party. Mm. One is A group, one is I group. These two groups are working as two different parties. So they are dividing all the constituencies and putting up their candidates. There is no common discussion. Mm. So winnability is never the criteria, but it is the apportioning of the positions between two groups.
No, Mr. Chacko, a lot of people will turn around and
people
say,
people like me who has...
Like Mr. Chacko says that there is A group and a B group and different groups. You know, there'll be an allegation that Mr. Chacko is unhappy because, you know, what he wants is not happening. And that can never be a criterion in a political party. The decision has to be collective and not what you feel is right. How do you respond?
No, I did not feel, I did not suggest anything. I did not ask for anything. I only want the election committee appointed by the AICC sit together, discuss the candidature of all the constituency. Let them decide whichever way they want, whichever names they want, let them take. I am not insisting on any name. I did not make any suggestion. I do not have any candidate. I only want a democratic functioning in the process of the selection of the candidates. That did not happen in Kerala, and that is my worry. That is my the basis of my decision.